Hi guys, it's me Chanelle here. Today, I'm going to talk about the Auckland Harbour Bridge. When people talk about New Zealand, the Auckland Harbour Bridge is an iconic structure everyone talks about. Auckland Harbour Bridge connects the Auckland Central Business District to the Auckland North Shore and beyond to Northland. This is a very important infrastructure to all Aucklanders, and when there is a problem with the bridge, usually all Auckland's roads become unusable due to heavy traffic. The original Royal Commission recommendations report came out in 1946, and it was for a 6-lane bridge, but the government at the time dropped it into 4 lanes by cutting off the 2 pedestrian lanes to save money. The Auckland Harbour Bridge construction started in 1954 and was completed in April 1959. It was officially opened on the 30th of May 1959. The actual construction only took 4 years for a whopping team of 1,000 workers. In 1959, approximately 11,000 vehicles crossed the bridge daily. But today, in 2021, we have over 200,000 cars crossing the bridge daily. Wow, a lot of cars, isn't it? There are 3 bridges within the Auckland Harbour Bridge. The section in the middle with the steep arches is the original 4-lane bridge, plus the 2 clip-ons on each side added in 1969 to provide more capacity. In total, there are 8 lanes now. Initially, this bridge was a toll road and used to charge 25 cents. That is about $5 in today's money. This toll was removed in 1984. The bridge is constructed of structural steel and reinforced concrete. It spans 1.2 kilometers across the Waitemata Harbour. The bridge reaches 64 meters above the water at its highest point. The bridge foundation started 33 meters below sea level. In the olden days, people used to say the bridge was cursed because a few people died as part of the construction process. Even today, people stop their cars and jump off the bridge to suicide. We have even seen someone trying to jump off in real life. It was scary. The bridge is monitored 24/7 and police in standby to protect the bridge and people. Some people call the bridge a coat hanger. This is because of its design, which allowed ships to pass under the bridge. A movable lane barrier called a tidal flow system was installed in 1990 to prevent crashes and improve rush hour traffic flows. 30 years later, we still have the system in place. New Zealand Transport Agency is the authority responsible to look after the bridge. Currently, about 160 people work on the bridge, and it costs approximately 4 million New Zealand dollars to maintain the bridge every year. The bridge would have a further life of between 20 and 40 years if truck restrictions were introduced in 10 to 20 years on the northbound clip-on. This means in our lifetime we will see a new harbour bridge or tunnel construction at some point. Let's see how long it will take to construct with modern-day technology. By looking at everything else, it will probably take way more than 4 years. That's enough facts for today. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and watch more videos. Bye!